If you've been a follower of the channel, then you've seen countless videos of mine about the Redmi Note 10 Pro. Out of all the phones that I've reviewed, I've spent the longest time with this incredible value of a device. I've made multiple reviews of it in the past, updating you guys of its overall performance when Xiaomi's latest MIUI 12.5 dropped, and even made a video about why this phone isn't for you. But today is a bit different. This is me sharing what I really think of the Redmi Note 10 Pro several months later. To all the subscribers, welcome back, and thanks for stopping by once again. And if you're new here, I create tech videos, so feel free to drop a sub to get notified of new content. As always, we start with the design. As a tech reviewer, I'm fortunate enough to test these new devices, getting a first-hand look at what's new on the market and how manufacturers try to one-up each other in the competition. In the mid-range market, it's tough to get a phone that can deliver the pillars of a good phone, which are design, display, performance, camera, and battery. But in the case of Redmi Note 10 Pro, the design is probably the best for the price. And largely the reason for that is the glass back panel. For the past decade, we have switched from plastic to metal to glass, and recently we found ourselves switching back to plastic simply because it's cheaper to manufacture. But not for this phone. Xiaomi was generous enough to keep the glass backing that makes the phone not only good looking but also better feeling in the hand. So as soon as you pick up this phone, you know that the design strikes right above its weight class. Sure, the plastic frame isn't something to write home about, but having a glass panel on the back makes a huge difference in the way the phone feels once you use it. You just don't get the same rigidity and heftiness from a plastic phone. This phone even has an IP53 rating and back-to-back Gorilla Glass 5 as the first line of defense against water splashes, dust, and scratches. But what really molds the premium experience of the design is how thin and light the Redmi Note 10 Pro feels in the hand. If there's one thing I would change here, that's probably to make the phone a bit narrower since my hands can barely reach the other side of the device when thumb typing, but otherwise, Xiaomi did a great job in the design department for this phone. The buttons are tactile, the fingerprint scanner is more reliable and faster than under the display solution, and you even get to keep the headphone jack in the microSD slot. If you take a look at the other brands at this range, I don't think you'll be able to see an equal of this device. Now, the performance of the Redmi Note 10 Pro is probably the least likable part, simply because it's using the good old Snapdragon 732G. We have seen the chip evolve from 730 to 730G to 732G with incremental upgrades here and there, but really with no significant gains in any areas. In 2021 and leading up to 2022, this phone is definitely more than enough to get you through your day-to-day needs and even with some light gaming on the side. But at some point, you're going to require more power as you change the way you use your phone. If you're the same type of user for the past several years, this might not be a problem. You can skip to other parts of this video. But if you expect yourself to get that itch to play the newest games, this phone won't let you do so, at least not in the terms of high frame rate gameplay, simply because there's not enough headroom provided by the chipset. All in all, this phone is enough to get you by for a few years, as long as you temper your expectations when it comes to more demanding apps and titles. There's a reason why I talked about the performance first, and that's because of the display. Xiaomi is one of, if not the only company that releases an affordable phone with an AMOLED display. And as we all know, AMOLED is miles better than LCD in terms of getting the punchiest colors and the inky blacks that we all love to have. But where Xiaomi really ended the competition is when they added a 120Hz refresh on the Redmi Note 10 Pro. Not only do you get to experience a high brightness, good looking display on a budget, but you also have the luxury to enjoy a smooth and fast display that can make any 60Hz device feel slow and sluggish. However, adding another 60 on top of another 60 is not just a simple display upgrade. Rendering 120Hz all the time requires power, with most of that power coming from the GPU more than the CPU. In the case of Redmi Note 10 Pro, which has an okay chipset, that 120Hz is not consistent most of the time. The easiest way for anyone to see the true effect of a fast panel is by scrolling. And that's where this phone is really good at. Whether it be its social media apps, browser, news, or the home screen, 120 is as clear as day. But due to the limitations of the chipset, that's about as far as you can get with a high refresh. Some of the most popular games simply can't go above 60Hz like PUBG and Wild Rift. Even playing at 90Hz makes a huge difference when it comes to shooter games. But let's not forget that this isn't a gaming phone. It's a well-balanced device that's more likely a jack of all trades, master of none. That said, you can forget about gaming on 120, but this is where my next point comes in. Software. For us consumers, when we simply can't purchase a phone for its powerful performance, we rely on the software to compensate for the lack of extra punch. With MIUI, the software is a hit or miss. At this point, after testing countless devices from both Xiaomi and Poco, I can say that each model came with the same roots but different fruits. For example, the Poco M3 Pro 5G that I reviewed came with a 90Hz display instead of 120, and a less powerful Dimensity 700 instead of Snapdragon 732G. Although it was using Poco Launcher, at the heart of its software is MIUI. And that version of MIUI happened to be one of my favorites because everything was smooth in terms of animations and general use. In the case of Redmi Note 10 Pro, MIUI is a miss. Some parts of the UI suffer from frame drops, which might make other users feel as if the phone is slowing down. The animations also feel unpolished and clunky, as if I'm using a better version of the software. These imperfections are normal at this range, but once you learn about a cheaper device performing way better, then you start thinking about what Xiaomi can do better for the software of the Redmi Note 10 Pro. There are a few workarounds to make the general performance of this phone better, like installing a third-party launcher, but it doesn't come with a negative, like losing gesture navigation in the process. MIUI has done a few things to make it like their software. They even provided a new control center, a la iPhone, to entice you. Google Discover feed on the left side of the home screen for Android enthusiasts, and tons of camera modes for regular users. But at the end of the day, MIUI is still a lottery when you purchase their budget phones. Despite the high refresh, the great design, and the AMOLED display of the Redmi Note 10 Pro, the main attraction of this phone is the 108-megapixel camera. Android devices love to play with numbers, and having 108-megapixel when 48 and 64-megapixel are the trends today, you will surely be astonished to see a flagship feature living inside a body of a budget phone. But unlike those top-tier phones, the quad camera on the back of this device is still a way for Xiaomi to get you with numbers. The only really useful lens here, other than the main camera, is the 8-megapixel ultra-wide lens. The other two, which are the macro and depth sensors, are more like icing on the cake to make the overall package look good from the surface. With a 108-megapixel camera, I don't think it's on the same level as the most expensive phones, but you can get really impressive photos with it. You just need plenty of lighting to get the best quality. If I'm outside, I'm confident I can get great shots with this camera, including the ultra-wide lens. But the big sensor doesn't only allow for better sharpness. Thanks to new technologies that come with it, it can also gather light more efficiently in extreme conditions and give you that background separation that actual professional cameras provide. But despite all that, the camera is still just a mid-range performer. While it does well in extreme scenarios, the sensor falls apart quickly in one area: indoors. As soon as you deprive the sensor of light, the noise reduction kicks in aggressively and the details become smudgy. At that point, you start to realize that even the biggest of numbers can't help you in facing the reality that numbers are just numbers. But one can always install a Gcam mod and everything will be solved. Honestly, I was a fan of Gcam back in the days, but I noticed that Xiaomi nearly has the same processing as Gcam that I don't bother installing anymore. Additionally, I just hate the way Gcam processes selfies. There's just too much HDR in my opinion. Lastly, let's talk about 5G. I don't think this phone missing out on 5G is a big deal. 5G phones are still relatively expensive. You see Realme 8 5G and Poco M3 Pro 5G. Although they are inexpensive 5G devices, try to remove the 5G from their name and see what you end up with. A budget 4G phone that's average in all aspects. That's a big compromise if you just want 5G at the end of the moniker of your phone. I also don't think that you should plan for 5G for the next couple of years. As it stands right now, availability is way limited and 5G data plans and promos are also relatively expensive compared to 4G. If you really want a no-compromise 5G phone in 2021, you have to have a budget that's north of this phone's price, like the Nord 2, Poco F3, or Poco X3 GT. So what else? Oh yes, the battery. It's still a tough phone to drain unless you're playing games or using mobile data connection all day. The headphone jack can't drive all headphones, but it's way better than having a dongle. And the stereo speakers are clear and decently loud. So that's it for the Redmi Note 10 Pro. We can finally bid farewell to this phone. As always, drop a sub or like if you feel supporting the channel, and until the next one, stay safe.